السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أمة المسلمين, إن شاء الله today we'll be looking at the 16th juz of the Quran and the first quarter of the 17th juz of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this portion of the Quran speaks about a very incredible story, and that is of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how he told Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam to go out and seek knowledge from this being that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had blessed too with knowledge. And they meet each other, and Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam requests that he accompany him on his travels. And Sayyidina Khadir alayhi salam mentions that it is only he won't be able to, he doesn't have the patience to bear with him during his travels. And Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam tells him that no, I will force myself to have patience when upon our travels. And Sayyidina Khadir alayhi salam gives him the instruction that you are not to ask of anything. Whatever I do, you are not to question me about what I do. And the first incident happens when they embark on a boat, upon which Sayyidina Khadir alayhi salam punctures a hole in the deck of this boat. And this infuriates Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. Why? Because Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam is looking at the act of kindness that these people who own the boat had extended towards them. And this is how Sayyidina Khadir alayhi salam is repaying the act of kindness. But Sayyidina Khadir alayhi salam reminds him of his condition, that you are not to ask about anything that I do. You are not to question me regarding anything that I do. And they carry on moving forward, and they come by this child that is playing, and Sayyidina Khadir alayhi salam claims his life. And this now infuriates Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam even more, that you're taking the life of an innocent child. And Sayyidina Khadir alayhi salam tells him, I told you that you would not have the patience. You cannot bear with me during my travels. And Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam gives him an ultimatum and tells him that if now I ask anything from you, then this is where we part ways. And they come by a town, and the Quran makes mention of the wretched habits that they had, that they didn't even entertain the guests. And upon the when they were on the way out, Sayyidina Khadir alayhi salam decides to, it comes by a wall that is on the verge of collapsing, and Sayyidina Khadir alayhi salam decides to fix up the wall. And Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam suggests to him that, you know what, you could have taken some money in lieu of your labor. And Sayyidina Khadir alayhi salam tells him that this is where we part ways. But I'll do you a favor and I'll tell you the reasoning behind what I did. And he mentions that as for the boat, there was a king that was taking and usurping the boats of the people along that river. So by puncturing a hole in the deck of the boat, the king will pass by and see the boat as defective and leave it behind. Afterwards, the family that owned the boat can fix up the boat and carry on their business as usual. As for the child, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had revealed to him that the child will grow up to be a mischievous child that will lead the parents into kufr. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not intend such. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intended that they have another child, and that will bring them closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why he did what he did. As for the wall, there was a person who had passed away and had left two orphans in the town, in the village. And Allah subhanahu, underneath that wall was the inheritance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intended to be preserved until the orphans reach adulthood, so they can benefit from that wealth that the parents had left behind for them. This is why he had did what he did. And this teaches us a very important lesson, and that is, things may not seem as how we see it. There is always a different interpretation and a hidden meaning and different dimensions that we do not understand or can comprehend. A famous saying in English is that don't judge a book by its cover. We might see something in one way, meanwhile there are different understandings and different meanings to it. In the next surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Sayyidina Maryam alayhi salam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how the miracle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given her, that she had born Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam without even the factor of a husband or a male entity involved in it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how she was about to go into labor, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told her that وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِذْعِ النَّخْلَ, that even in that state Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told her to shake the branches of the tree, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give her fresh dates. And this shows you that behind what we need or what we want in life, there is always an effort. Imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would give Sayyidina Maryam alayhi salam fruits that were out of season, but yet at this instance Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told her the least you should do is shake the branches of the tree. This shows us that behind what we want, there is always an effort that is needed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the next surah speaks about Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam and the courage that he had given him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthened him with his brother and granting his brother nubuwa and making him also a prophet. But subhanallah, look at the task at hand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is a person that had massacred so many children. This is a person that had enslaved an entire nation. This is a person that was given everything, but called his people to worship him. And this is a person that announced amongst his people that Ana Rabbukumul A'la, I am your highest Lord, you're supposed to worship me. Yet, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks and sends Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam to him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't say, go and scold him, go and reprimand him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا, go and speak to him in a soft and appropriate manner. And this shows us that this deen, this religion that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us is supposed to be given to others in a soft and appropriate manner. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the understanding. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala towards the ending of this surah speaks about certain people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will resurrect on the day of Qiyamah blind. And they will complain to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, telling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, Ya Allah, in this life, when I was alive, I could see, I had my eyesight. Yet why is it that on the day of judgment, when I am resurrected again, I am blind? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell them, كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَاتِنَا, that in this worldly life, we sent our signs to you, but you chose to be oblivious of them, and you turn a blind eye towards them. Hence, on the day of judgment, we have resurrected you as a blind person. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the ability to see his signs, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to resurrect us on the day of judgment amongst those that can see and not those that are blind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the end of this portion of the Quran speaks about the inevitable truth, and that is death. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that we are all going to die. Kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut. We all know that we're going to die. The question that you and I should be asking ourselves is not whether we're going to die, whether or not we're going to die, but rather, are we prepared for what comes after death? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the ability to make adequate preparations. Jazakumullahu khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.